Okay, so we are in the draft.
Oh, I can see Miss French Ghost Person being banned very quickly.
Okay, there's the immediate Arc Warden ban. Yeah, not a surprise there, because he's spectacularly broken if you know how to play him.
Axe is in the pool this time, so maybe we'll see some Chris Axe.
I would like to see a Chris Axe. I think that would be good. Yeah. It's a lot more carries this time. Or a lot more variety of carries. Okay, Tidehunter's ban, not a massive surprise. There's not really anyone else in there who's crazy broken at the moment. We might see another Viper ban. That's not a huge shock.
Is this where they ban OD? Because he's just annoying.
Bad a lot of time. Okay, AM ban. And who's going to be the last ban? There's the Viper ban. I wonder what. Are they just. I think they're just banning.
Well, alright, the OD first pick.
I think they're just banning Silencer because Chris really hates Silencer. Like, on principle. Not because he doesn't like playing against him. He just thinks he's an incredibly anti fun hero and doesn't enjoy having him in games. Because I don't think anyone on the Jammys is famous for their Silencer play.
No, not really.
Picking the OD first is a bold move because, unlike in Captain's Mode, once the initial bans are done, you don't have to worry about bans. You only have to worry about someone else picking the hero. And I can't imagine that the Dukes would have picked OD in the first two picks. So you're giving away quite a lot of your strategy. On the other hand, you know.
You need more int than him.
Yeah. But I mean, he steals int so fast now. Axe. And there's the Chris Axe, hopefully.
Axe.
If they manage to get a aggressive dual lane in their hard lane, I mean, Disruptor Axe is a pretty scary combi.
I mean, if Chris wants to be a dick, he'll just go and creep skip on the off lane. And if, okay, they're going all out on their pick carries first, it's a risky strategy because you're giving away an awful lot about your counters. Bane is quite a good counter to Axe, just because you can Nightmare him and walk away. But if they don't have good disables in lane, Axe will just run them over.
Yeah, I mean, the Astral Prison probably also helps.
Yeah, well, the thing is, Astral Imprisonment, I mean, obviously since they changed it, it's got very different usage now. People don't tend to, they just tend to take one value point in it and not really do anything else. I suspect that's a carry Naga. I can't see it being a support Naga. I mean, it could be, but I think it's unlikely. Okay.
All right, Ogre Magi. I like that captain.
That'll be a support Gunka. Almost certainly. I can't. Oh no, it's a support Naga. Okay, I take it all back. So, is that going to be a Robobin Gunka? A Coccyx Sniper? Yeah, it is. That's a safe lane Kunkka. That surprised me. We do not see Kunkka played as a carry a lot these days. Not in pro games, anyway. And I'm treating this as a pro game, however crazy that may be of me to do.
Love how...
Oh, hang. What? Okay, so that's going to be Sladar solo off, do we reckon? Or dual lane?
Who is it?
He's probably going to be solo.
Fuck DC.
And of course, here's
the DC. I'd just like to point out again that one of VOP's most used words in chat is restarting.
Okay, so again, I can't select any of the heroes. So before anyone tries it, no. Okay, who just clicked Bane?
Me.
Okay, so you select heroes. Kryzn,
is that Ogre?
Yeah, Kryzn, don't select any heroes, and I won't select any heroes, and then we should be able to tell what's going on fairly easily.
Just...
Alright. Zoom around the map, right?
Yeah. Who just selected Axe?
Not me.
I didn't either.
Okay, well now it's just decided to partially select Axe and flick between Axe and Ogre.
I mean, Axe just selects himself, you know. That's the kind of champ he is.
Okay, that's fixed again. It's bizarre, I don't know what's going on with this. Okay, so now it's flicking between Axe and Sladar. Fuck knows. Right, so we have Vopper on the OD, Kian on the Sladar, and Lect on the Gyro. Bloody Teddy on the Ogre and Ninjarox, who has now changed his name, on the Bane. Meanwhile, Chris's Beard Strat, Beard and Mermaid Strat, is good. They do have a dual aquatic theme with the Naga Kunkka. Robobin is on the Kunkka. Dart on the Disruptor, Chris obviously on the Axe, Coxix on the Sniper, and Zoe on the Naga. Now, do we think we're going to see an AoE style Naga where starts off as support and then they just kind of say, fuck it, build a Radiance?
I mean, I think it really depends. The nice thing about the Naga pick is that it's a bit flexible. So, you know, if they manage to snowball their early game, then I can totally see that happening. I mean, given how the last game went, but I like the team composition of the Jammys this time a little more just because the champions they have, the characters they're playing are a little bit more comfortable, I think, for the people playing them. So, I mean, you know, that always makes a big difference. I know that Ninja Rox likes playing Bane, so that helps a lot. And again, they're stacking up, you know, the four-man.
They just want to secure that rune.
Okay, I have to say, stream's gone tits up, so I've just restarted it. Hopefully it'll recover.
You can tell that the mids aren't tryhard because both Curias aren't on the edge of the ancient.
Okay, so it looks like the bottom rune's going to go to the Jammys uncontested, and the top rune goes to the Jukes, although slightly contested, but not much.
Well, Jammys have done exactly the same as the Jukes warded off that the pool camp. It was exactly the same spot.
Oh, surprisingly though, Axe is going.
G-E-G-E.
So I apologize wholeheartedly for that. I think it was when Dota crashed, it upset things. Okay, stream's working now.
Alright, nice. So yeah, we actually have an Axe in the safe lane.
By himself.
I mean, the setup potential with the Bane and the Slaughter is actually pretty good. But yeah, then you don't want to man fight.
Yeah, you just gotta make sure you don't do it near a creep wave. Meanwhile, top.
They're putting a lot of pressure on this gyro.
Yeah, well, it's not really surprising. I mean, we've got the Naga and Kunkka and the Disruptor top. I'm not really sure what the Disruptor's doing. Seems to be wandering around a bit. Can somebody select the Disruptor for me and tell me what skill build is? What's he taking first?
Sure. He went to Thunderstrike first.
Yeah, okay. So no early glimpse ganks. Looks like Nindrox is going back to the fountain. He's taken a lot of harass. Although, I mean, he's still on half health and he's got four tangos, so it does seem a little premature to head back to the fountain, but nonetheless. Mid, meanwhile, unsurprisingly, Sniper is out CSing the OD. It's not going to be a fun lane for OD, I don't think. Oh, they're going in on the Ogre. This could be a raided Ogre. That's a Torrent. Oh, he's caught both of them. Gyro's con in. Oh, and his Rocket Barrage got eaten by the Creep Wave. That was unfortunate. I think this is going to be a dead Ogre. Oh, no, they're chasing it, but he's been glimpsed all the way back to the other side of the tower. And that...
Oh, nice, done.
Disruptor. Yeah, that glimpse was not what he wanted to do. So that's a one-for-one trade. That could have been a lot worse.
Ninja is coming with Bane. He's pinging him out.
Yeah, but I suspect the Naga's just going to TP out. No, it's not. It's coming back in.
Kunkka's Bane.
He does have boots, though. Naga with boots is very fast. With the net. They're just not going to stop him. Oh, but they've got the... they've got the stuns from the Ogre. No, oh no!
But you should have stunned.
Yeah, he used the... Nindrox just needed one right click on the Naga and he'd got the kill, but he turned his attention to the Kunkka. Mistakes were made.
Zeus ult now.
Yeah.
That really would have been better to stun.
Yeah, if you got the stun.
It also would have done actually a lot more damage.
Yeah, if you'd done the stun rather than the ignite, that would have been a dead Naga Siren. And they know the Bane's there, so they're going to play it very defensively. It does also mean, though, that the Axe will just have basically complete free farm because the Slardar cannot kill him. Unless, you know, he does something stupid like dive the T1 really hard, but even then I think Axe is tanky enough to survive. Vopra's looking a little worse for wear. I mean, actually, to be fair, the Slardar's getting very good CS. He's doing better than the Axe. He's 14-5. The Axe is 9-0.
Oh, and nice. He got the region rune. That's very lucky.
Yeah, and Axe doesn't get anything. Meanwhile, the Sniper does pick up the Bounty rune, but you know, he was already on full health and mana anyway, so the regen wouldn't have helped him that much. He doesn't have a bottle. This top lane is very bad for the Jammys. Gyro, I mean, he's got some last hits, but he's losing out hard to the Kunkka.
Yeah, Teddy just tried to get a clarity, but it was full, so it just went straight back on the courier.
That is unfortunate indeed. Yeah, and there's the...
Oh, Kian's going in hard on bot.
Yeah, not a good idea. You do not want to fight Axe in a great wave.
Yeah. I'm also not entirely sure what the build here is for Teddy.
Looks like they're trying to wrap around the top. Again, Andlex taking a lot of damage from the creeps. He needs to be careful.
He's just selfed up.
Yeah. The problem they've got is that the Kunkka harass is pretty big. How many points has he got in Tidebringer? He's got 2 points in Tidebringer, so it's not that bad yet, but it's one of those things. It's like laning against Necro. Like, despite your best efforts, you just slowly lose HP.
Yeah. Also, I'm not sure if pulling now is the best call.
No, pulling now was probably...
Given that the lane's pushing hard anyways.
I mean, it's not going to be too bad as long as they pull this wave off the tower. But the problem is, the Dukes are smart enough, they're going to go and contest it. And then they'll get... I mean, there's nothing left to get now, but... Oh, it's okay. He might be okay because the torrent was already used. But that minus armor from the Naga does so much damage.
Yeah, I'm also not a big fan of this Ogre build, because I think a Mango, for example, really, really helps.
Oh yeah, I mean, Ogre is so tanky. What items has he got at the moment? Somebody please.
So, he's got a Tango Shoes, Circle It Down.
Yeah, no, that's a bad choice. I always go Mango on Ogre. A, because he has quite a small mana pool to start with, and it's very helpful to have, but also with the extra regen. Like, he already has, like, 4.5 regen.
Third regen, yeah, so if you...
Meanwhile, bottom, Gein's in a lot of trouble, but... I mean, he's not going to be able to do much. He's hit 6, though. But so has the Axe. So if he's a little bit overly aggressive, Axe will just dunk him.
As a dead Andelect top.
Yep, it is. And they are going to get the Disruptor as a trade, but that's not a good trade.
Bane's just hanging around near mid.
Meanwhile, Sniper's just sitting there, merrily pinging against Taz. So he's going to try and wrap around behind. Oh, no. The problem is, I think, his Coxix. Coxix doesn't know this is happening, but now he does. And he's got the... But what's he going to do? He's now got no mana for the Brain Sap. Oh, he's just... It still does damage, though, when it drops. But no, he Brain Sapped a creep instead of the side. Oh, he did get a Sniper, though. But I think this might cost them two. Cost them Kian, though. Yeah, that's a dead Kian. Oh, no, Axe hasn't got enough mana for the dunk, but it doesn't matter. Yeah, mistakes were definitely made there. Not only did he imprison a creep rather than the sniper, but then Bane brain sapped a creep instead of the sniper. And Bane didn't even have the excuse because the creep was quite a long way away from the sniper. So, bit of a misclick there, unfortunately. Meanwhile, top, the Kunkka's now on his own. If they knew this, they'd just go. Like, if they get the stun and the rocket barrage away from a creep,
from
creeps, they'll kill him. But I just don't think they want to risk it because they don't know where the Naga and the Disruptor are. Again, part of the problem is that the Jammys just don't have a lot of vision.
Oh, they're just bottle crowing. There we go. They're like, just bottle crowed.
They've got no wards on the map right now, the Jammys.
Just took Ninja like 5 seconds.
Oh, and that's another dead Andalite. Oh, and they've glimpsed back the Ogre, and he's going to get assassinated, and that's a very good Ogre. That was a fail vote.
Not necessary.
And
but it's about sending a message, you know?
But I don't think he's going to... Has that sniper got a haste rune? I really hope he has. He hasn't got the effect for me. Because he's
he's not.
How is he that fast?
Yeah, he's got
sprint.
Phase boots.
Even with phase boots, that's just ridiculously fast.
Yeah, he's 401.
Crazy. Okay, so the Naga, quite low HP. Axe, just lurking.
Yeah, I mean he's that. About 600 gold of the Blink Dagger. Once yeah, that goes online, that's going to be really scary.
He's got 33 last hits as well.
Oh, he's got the call, but he's not going to do enough damage. He's nowhere near any creeps or anything. Oh, no, however. No, I don't think. Unless. Yes,
this is where we get the bashes.
Oh, he's sprinted. That's always risky. Can you get a bash? Can you get a bash?
I should have. No bashes. Should have crushed.
Ah, he just used it.
Yeah. It was off cooldown.
It's only a 6-second cooldown. It's sorry, 8-second cooldown. It's ridiculously short. And we have the TP rotation in from the Naga just to back up the axe and make sure it doesn't get killed. Meanwhile,
then just hang around.
But there's no one here.
You just put
the Iron Talon on the.
All right, so they're setting up, I think, to. Ah, but he was pinged out.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're setting up top to try and like gank somebody, but there just isn't anybody to gank because Kunkka's back in base. Oh no, he's TP back.
All right, now he's
okay,
back.
So they might be able to do this if Bane doesn't show himself. Robin's playing very, very cautiously because he knows they're all missing.
Oh, and the courier is coming to Bane. And...
Oh no!
Run, little courier, run!
And the courier's going to make it out, but that just completely ruined any
back.
Chance.
Oh,
they have
but I
ganking.
Mean, he's maybe if he.
No, he's.
Oh, he's hidden.
Oh my god! The sick Jukes, the hot Jukes.
Oh,
the hottest of Jukes. Oh.
And he's got boost back up.
Yeah, I don't.
Oh, he's dead.
Yeah, hopefully the ignite will slow him enough.
This is where he does it.
Yeah, he's dead.
Here
but,
we go.
Oh, and in comes the axe. But I think he's just going to run away.
Oh, okay, but a four-man rotation top. Oh, but sniper is also there. Oh. Okay.
Dunked.
Oh, and the glimpse back.
Dunk.
Oh, that did not do as much as it maybe should have. Oh, okay, but at least a return kill there.
That's a sad boss.
Is he going to be a dead? No.
Ooh,
oh,
nice stun. Okay.
No, that is a dead drop.
Oh,
however.
And there was
he
the torrent.
He should not have gone back in. He was being a bit indecisive there, and it cost him his life. Have a look at the net worth. So the Dukes are about 2,000 ahead, but it's not, you know, a straight line. It looks like they've got a reasonable handle on things. It's definitely nowhere near as one-sided as the early parts of the last game were. The only problem, my concern, is this gyrocopter who's 0-4 at this point. Pretty much all the kills are on the Ogre, which is nice for the Ogre, but it's not great for the team. Oh, and they're wrapping round. Luckily, they're going
and
the Ogre.
Is a... Yeah.
Yeah.
But Axe has the Blink Dagger now, and so they can just cut the creep wave.
Yeah,
and
there's four of them there. They're just going to sit there and...
They have no vision.
Oh, no. What? He went... Ninja went very far forward there. Oh, incoming boat.
Oh, another fail
another
boat.
But they're going to glimpse back the Bane, and the Bane is... Oh, no! Nightmares himself! But taken off by the Axe, unable to get the deny. Good play there by Chris.
Okay, but Vop just killed... Okay, with some help from Kian. Just killed Kotsik in mid.
Wasn't paying attention to that. That was an important kill, because that sniper is leading the last hits. Let's have a look at that fight recap. So, yeah, it didn't cost them very much either. They didn't have to drop any ults or anything.
Just looking at the wards, and neither wards are that great.
No, but at least the Jammys have got some wards on the board now, because they were completely blind for a while. Both of those top wards are now a bit useless, because that top T1's gone. But...
Now Sniper's going bot. Well, they're all going bot.
So Vop's getting some farm here in the creep camps.
He's got his drums.
Yeah, I'm not convinced on drums for an OD. Oh, that's a dead sick in. Oh, just get killed by the... I think Axe was mid-dunk there anyway, so I don't think he would have made it out even without Disruptor Thunderstrike on him.
But I always am more happy when an Axe gets a kill than when a Sniper gets a kill.
Everybody's happy when an Axe gets a kill. Axe is going Blade Mail there.
Yeah.
But this could be a dead Kunkka. Oh no, Vopra switched targets again! But he does still get the kill with the Gyro cooldown, helping him out there. I'm not sure whether these players on the Jammys are playing with the auto attack on or something, because that's a couple of times now that they've been attacking someone and then they just switch targets to a creep.
Oh, and there is the call.
Oh, it's the blink call from the Axe. That's very nice. That's a dead Gyrocopter again. However, they do kill the Axe as a trade around, and that's a dominating streak from the Axe going to the OD. That's a lot of gold.
So if we just look at the gold swing, well, okay.
I mean, that's a 1,000 gold swing.
Swing, yeah. That's not
bad
at all.
And that doesn't show the kill of the Kunkka either. Oh, speaking of which, that's a Torrent boat, and that is the first successful boat of the game. I think Vokra might be done. Oh, he drops his ult. Gets the kill on the Naga.
Oh, nice prison.
Banishes the Kunkka. However, he now can't imprison himself. And he survives. That was presumably only a level 1 ult from Sniper. So the Jammys are actually doing a pretty good job of holding their own here. I mean, I'd say that the advantage is still sitting with the Dukes just because they're on the aggressive at the moment. But it's, you know, 11 for 12. The gold swing, it's only about 2,000 in the Duke's favour, which is not too bad. That was a not particularly impressive glimpse. But they are now just 4-man, 5-manning on the mid-tower. And
Slaughter is not there too.
Oh, no, the Jammys have gone in to defend it, and I think that was the mistake. Oh, however, they've got the Bane ult on the Axe, but it just doesn't do enough.
And Axe is going to get crushed.
We've got the Slaughter coming in from behind. He gets the 2-man crush, but there's just too much damage, I think. He does manage to pick up the Sniper.
That's the Blame ult.
And Vopra gets the Axe as well. If he just turns and attacks, he might be able to kill every time.
That's
of course, every
so
time.
Oh, nice!
You have to remember, every time OD hits intelligence hero, he's not only sapping mana, but he's also sapping damage. Oh, however,
that's a mega kill to Disruptor.
Gets the kill. Why? I think he just. Oh, for a moment there, I thought he might have killed Bloody Teddy. Not quite sure why he nightmared him. But yeah, that that was a lot of gold.
That was another 1,000 gold swing.
Yeah, this overall swing was still nearly 1,500 gold in favour of the Jammys. So, again, most of it going to the Ogre, who came out of that fight 1,300 gold up. So the question is, where are we looking on the Ogre? Ogre is... he's got a ring of health. I wonder where he's going. Do you reckon he's
probably
going?
Etherlands.
Etherlands, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of Ethelens on the Ogre. Right, let's have a look. So actually, Vop is leading the net worth by 600-700 gold over the Axe, who is the second highest in net worth. The Kunkka's quite a way down. Ogre is actually fourth right now.
Well, the Dire, or the Jammys, they're actually ahead XP by 3k.
Oh yeah, they are. I think that last fight was a big swing for them. Even though they didn't get a lot of gold, they got a lot of XP. Kian getting very lucky there.
A Naga ult.
But he's blinked straight into the Naga, and this is going to be a 2-man call. Beautifully timed. I think this is a very dead Bane. Oh, but Chris whiffs the ult. Still, the Bane goes down, but Kian, however, is dead. The Sniper's going to kill him, or the Battle Hunger will finish him off. And oh, the Gyro's coming in. They could still do this, but the Sniper with the Mask of Madness just attacks so fast. Vopra, he's doing his best. He's got the 4-staff away. Torrent misses. On the Kunkka, so he just blinks away. And
I would have stayed. If I was Vopra, I would have stayed attacking the Kunkka.
I don't know. It's very risky. If you get caught in a Torrent boat, you're dead. Although, actually, I don't think the Kunkka had the mana to do it. Like, he has got haste rune now.
Because Vopra had 40 stolen.
Yes. This is the thing with OD, like, especially when you look at it, like, the Int Steal lasts for 50 seconds at all levels, which isn't that long when you compare it to, like, Slark's Essence Shift at max level, but nonetheless, it lasts a long time in fights, and you can very quickly stack up an awful lot of stolen ints and therefore damage. And of course, it's pure damage as well, so...
It's not used a drum charge yet, either.
No, which again, gives you that attack speed boost.
I wonder if he's forgotten that he's got drums.
Quite possibly. A lot of people forget about the drums active. It's easy to do. I know I do it quite frequently.
They've
got the Bane ult on the Naga. The glimpse to cancel it, but immediate imprisonment. But now they're just going to back out, I think. Yeah, Jukes don't want to fight this. You don't want to fight uphill into the Ancients. It's asking for trouble. So, the Gyro is very poor. He's got an Aquila and Phase and a Morbid Mask, and that's it. Kian's got the Blink Dagger. I think Nindrox is going for an Aether Lens as well. Aether Lens is finished on Bloody Teddy, and I think he's presumably going Mech next, which seems like a bad idea. Ogred really doesn't have the mana pool early on to support a Mech, but I guess they don't have anyone else who really could build it otherwise. OD, I suppose, could, but... I think we're kind of... We're more or less past the days of all the mids building Mechs. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. The good old days for a few months before they nerfed the mana cost, where every single mid in the game just built a Mech as their first item.
Oh, my data just crashed.
Oh. Right, Konka's got an Invis rune.
And they're so rotating into the mid. I think they're going to try and jump this Ogre. Oh, he needs to. He's playing very aggressive. I think he needs to get back quite a bit. Kryzn is obviously waiting for a good opportunity. Oh, but they've got a sentry. If Konka comes forward, they know he's there. Kian just needs to ult him, and then they'll have vision, but he's just wandered out of sentry range again. He's just sitting there on the edge of sentry range, and now the D ward in the sentry. I think Robobin must have realised that Kian had spotted him.
Alright, a nice pulse.
Bit of the good old-fashioned lag. It's like a proper pro game of Dota.
Exactly.
I'm just waiting for the DDoS. Okay, so net worth is pretty much level now. Only 1,000 lead in favour of the Dukes. It's kind of been on a downhill run ever since that big teamfight mid. And yeah, the Dire are now 5,000 XP ahead. So part of the problem they've got is that their supports on the Hot Dukes are still only level 8. And while the Bane is only level 7 on Jammy, everyone else has been getting good levels. So if we look at it, yeah, actually the Gyro is only level 10. He needs to really farm hard. He's kind of struggling. But I mean, as we said, he's 2 for 7 now, but he was 0 for 5 at one point. Not a lot of buybacks available.
All right, mid-game bathroom breaks. Nice.
I mean, really, they should have gone to the bathroom before the game started. I'm not pro enough to remember the key presses for the different displays. I'm now going to have to find a way to stitch those two recordings together as well. That'll be fun.
Alright, I'm back. I went to the toilet. What happened?
Everyone went to the bathroom.
My data crashed
okay,
again.
Okay, we're back in.
What, was there a stop?
Yes. Okay.
Can someone give me an invite?
You should just be able to reconnect.
Oops.
You left the game?
Yeah.
You can't get back in then.
That's fine. Game is hard.
You can just probably go to spectate.
I can just go to the stream, actually.
Yeah.
Well, the stream will be delayed, actually.
Well, it depends. Did they actually put a delay on the stream? I don't know if they did.
No, but I mean, this stream is just like 10 seconds or so behind.
It's close enough that you can still provide commentary, even if you can't provide play-by-play. It's a professional outfit we're running here. Right, so they're doing a lot better on the warding front.
All right,
time,
so they're...
Yeah, that was...
Yeah, they're coming in.
But the Gnar is so fast. However, they just basically nearly saved that Bane.
Oh, he just got a glimpse back.
Yeah, but they glimpsed him out of the Berserker's Call. And again, Bane's one of the least useful heroes to get in Berserker's Call because his attack speed's so slow. Oh, that's an X on the OD. Oh, he should have imprisoned himself. Nah, it's just not the
And there is the dunk.
He needs to get those early hits on just to do a bit of damage and really build it up. But that was a really good ult by the Gyro. But he's just going to take so much damage from the Static Storm. He's dead. Oh, or maybe not. Lovely multicast there. Top skill plays from Bloody Teddy.
Oh, the blink, the X back. Not so safe harbor,
eh? I think this is a... Oh, no, this is not good. Oh, the multicast again! These are some sick multicasts from the Ogre. Really getting his money's worth from the ultimate. Yeah, he is going mech. He's nearly finished the Buckler.
So the wards are still not amazing.
No, but they're better than they were last game. What time have you got on the stream?
23 minutes, 20. Just at like 5 seconds now.
Okay, so you're about 10 seconds behind then. So that's fine. So net worth is now in the favour of the Jammys, actually. They're obviously farming very well because they are managing to keep ahead despite the engagements being pretty equal.
The other problem is, of course, that even though the Jammys are winning fights, they are not really getting any objectives out of
it. No, this is the thing. Again, they haven't got a single Terran. They've lost all their T1s. On the upside, they have not taken any significant damage to the T2s. And the Dukes don't really have a really heavy pushing lineup.
Well, once the sniper gets going.
Vop's going for his BKB. It's just a recipe away.
BKB. Oh, and we've just had another disconnection.
And here we know why Vop says restart so much.
That's a good point. You can try just watching it in client. If you just watch me, or if you watch somebody else, if you watch one of the players, you should be able to watch the game in client, and that should be live because there's no delay on it. So you'll then get what we're watching. Thank you for pointing that out, Skoo. I really should have thought of that.
Shout out to Skoo.
I did say that like 5 minutes ago, but nobody listens to
me. I apologize.
Kappa.
It's okay. I have an accent. It's really hard to take me seriously.
You are very much our Pimp Muckle.
Actually, yeah. No, it's more delayed in game.
Is it?
If I watch you.
Okay. Weird.
It's just about to be paused.
Oh, it's probably because then there's an actual like 3 minute delay, right?
Actually, I say that. No, I think it's... Have you just unpaused?
No.
No. Yeah, so it's... Yeah, it's pretty delayed.
Okay, we'll just jump back onto the stream then and watch it that way. Maybe they did put a delay on it.
Yeah.
We wouldn't see it. As broadcasters, we wouldn't see it, so...
Yeah, okay. I just saw Vop last hit like he was before.
Yeah, we're back up and running then. I guess they want to stop stream sniping, which I'm helping by broadcasting it live with no stream delay. So, my bad, guys.
Game's hard.
So, I think... Late game, if the Naga doesn't go carry, I think that the Jammys actually have this relatively okay. The problem is... Oh, okay, and they just killed the Axe in the jungle, which I did not spot, and they got away scot-free. Well played.
Yeah, the axe basically tried to kill the Bane, but he had backup, so a bit of an aggressive blink there.
I mean, you kind of have to on axe, but it's just unfortunate that there were people waiting for him.
Yeah, and the Dukes are taking... I think they've decided that they need to back up a little bit, farm up, before they can take more fights.
I mean, the thing is, Kunkra and Sniper can both be quite scary late game, but, I mean, OD and Gyro, I think, will out-carry them. The only thing they've really got to worry about, as I said, is if the Naga starts getting farm and then starts blip pushing, because they don't have... Apart from the Gyro, they don't have good clearance, really. Ogre's okay with Ignite, but... OD and Bane are not good at really clearing creeps. So that's the BKB complete on Vopra, which should be good. The only thing they've got that goes through BKB... Actually, Naga Net goes through BKB, doesn't it? But... Yeah.
But so far, when he's died, there's a callman.
That's a very, very.
Oh, that is very dead, Teddy. And that was a dominating streak, so.
Yeah, that's the other problem with having all your kills on the ogre. So that was nearly to 1200 gold swing. Just from killing the ogre.
I suppose that kill going to the axe kind of. Redeems him dying multiple times.
Uh-oh, the trash talk has started.
Alright, we're running a clean cast here, okay? We don't like this kind of behavior.
Okay, so... Dukes are just...
And I mean, the most...
Farm the enemy jungle. And they have the ward up. What is that ward? Oh, it's a frog with a... Oh, it's like a deep sea angler thing, isn't it? With the eye on it. Okay, and that's Bane dewarding. Nice job doing that.
I love how you're focusing on the ward.
Well, I mean...
Oh, they saw that.
The thing is that unlike the last game, the Jammys not only had no vision, but they weren't taking away the Duke's vision either. This game, they've been a lot better at dewarding. And making sure that they take away the vision, even if their vision isn't great. But if neither of you have good vision, then at least you're on sort of reasonably even footing.
Yeah, that was a lucky ward that Bane placed just as they approached the vision area.
No, but given that they have that ward and that they're stacking up there, I'm a little surprised that they're not rotating, because I mean they're just... with a sniper. Although the sniper is a little bit out of position there. Okay, he's...
That's aggressive move in. Oh, and that was a beautiful blink away. This could be a dead Slardar. Oh, and... Nope, there goes the song. That's a really good song from the Naga. Isolating out the Slardar. And this could be a dead Jar as well, because he's got nothing. Oh, and he's going to get one of them back. Oh, and the boomerang assassinate there from the sniper. Following the glimpse.
Yeah, I mean, the main forces of the Jammys there got just zoned really hard by the boat and by the Naga, so...
Yeah, it was a really good song by the Naga. She split the team down the middle and just kept them from coming into hell.
Ooh, Dire, you gotta fortify them, their structures, good work.
I'm not sure about that glyph.
Oh, beautiful. Right. Oh no! He's been fountain glimpsed. But the axe could still be dead here. The axe is dead. But I think this might be a trade. Oh, the sick multicast! And the BKB pop. Beautifully done by Vop. But I think they're going to get away. The other two are going to get away. That was really nice. The fountain glimpse was good, but in the end, the damage was already done. He'd already got in and got us the crush off. Oh, I think the Jammys have realised they need to start taking some objectives.
Kane is shit-talking that mad.
Yeah, that's what he does.
I mean, you know, he is... What is he? He's 2 for 7, Irish. So probably not in a great position to be doing it.
Well, I mean, as we have all learned from playing a lot of Dota ourselves, right? The people who talk the most shit tend to be the ones who are not doing so well.
This is true.
I mean, you know, I mean, it is a, I would say, almost an iron rule of Dota that the person who
really
feeds
nasty.
The most says GG easy at the end.
Naga's song is not up. Naga's song was up, this could be horrible, because she could just invis in song and then the rest of the Duke's TP in. Luckily for them, song was on cooldown. There wasn't really much she was going to be able to do. Even if she'd gone in for a sneaky deny or something, I think it would have been too risky. If they'd caught her, she'd have been dead. So, as it stands, net worth is still just basically dead zero. Slightly in favour of the Dire over the last, like, 10 minutes, but not by a lot. XP is still about 7.5k in favour of the Jammys.
That is a stack and a half.
Where's that?
Ancients.
Oh yeah, the Radiant Ancients. I'm assuming that the Axel Tanker.
The Conquer will probably.
Yeah. But, I mean, that said, Vop is now 4k ahead of the Conquer, who's second highest in net worth. The Gyro is catching up, he's now fourth in net worth. He does have a BKB, but he doesn't have the damage at the moment. He's still only level 14. That isn't actually that bad. I was just Vop's level 18, and that kind of threw me. Vop's got two sets of boots. I mean, to be fair, he's got four legs. Yeah, he's got four legs, so maybe he needs the two sets of boots.
You know, one for running fast and one for hitting fast. That makes sense.
I mean, yeah, he'll probably get rid of the treads when he needs the slot. I'm surprised he's not got them on in, to be honest. But...
yeah, knowing Bob, he's probably trying to be a little bit careful because he's worried about just being caught out.
Of course, the other good thing is that, obviously, OD's Arcane Orb does bonus damage against illusions. So
looks like Slada was trying to rush.
That's a bit ambitious.
Yeah, I mean, well, you can do it, because, I mean, you know, the damage amp you get from Amplified Damage is remarkable, but even so, doing it solo is very risky, yeah. And the Dukes have got good wards in and around Roche, so... see, this is the problem. They've got a sentry up there, but they've got no vision of it, so they don't realise that they could de-ward that.
Alright, just Kunkka just took the stack, so that's probably going to give him a lot of extra money.
Yeah, he's just gained about 1,000 net worth from that stack, maybe 2,000. Probably 1,200, 1,500. So the question is, what items he going? Because he hasn't really got much yet. He's got Blink BKB and drums, to be fair. But he's lacking damage. Coxix, I'm assuming, well, he could be going Deso or he could be going Maelstrom. He's going BKB. My mistake. I think they're all going BKB. Axe has nearly got his BKB. The only person on the Dukes, the only people on the Dukes who aren't going BKB are Naga and Disruptor. Everyone else is going for it. This could be interesting coming to teamfight because a lot of the damage that's coming out of a lot of the burst damage coming out of the Jammys is magic.
Although on the plus side, the Gyro has caught up a little bit, and so I mean he's now a smoke from the Jammys.
Are they going to try and Roche, or are they just trying to catch somebody? Oh no, they're going on the Kunker. I think they want to go on the Kunker. Yeah, they do. However, they've got a disruptor there. Disruptor's going to break the smoke, and they've got the ward. They've got the observed ward up there. Oh, it's a beautiful static storm. Only catch the OD, and he just pops the BKB. And wow, that ult just
wrecked.
Obliterated the disruptor, as you might imagine. Axe is very dead.
Nice.
That's a very good fight for the Jammys. It did cost them two BKB charges, but I think you'd agree that's worth it for nearly 4,000 gold swing.
Yeah.
3,500.
And then at least they can get another Well, they can actually get probably two towers out of
yeah,
this.
Yeah, OD's going to try and get a top tower, which he should be able to do, although he's got no creep wave at the moment. Bottom should be easy with the gyro and the bloodlust from the ogre, which is something that should never be underestimated. Like, the extra attack speed you get from bloodlust is huge.
Yeah. Actually, I really like the synergy between the bloodlust on the OD, because that really helps
yes,
with the arcane
orb. Difference. The amount of thing you can steal is huge.
Mustn't forget that Bloodlust can be cast on towers now.
Yep. But people always forget.
The Dire is now 5,000, almost 6,000 gold up. That's
a big swing as well. That swing could continue for a bit more with the angle and that when we get the next tick update. I mean, I know kills don't mean much, but they are 5 kills ahead. Oh, and Keen's just blinked up onto a cliff.
Well, Slaughter did it last game, right? So, just about sending a message here.
True. And the bottom, top tower's being pushed in on really hard as well. There's another big creep wave coming down behind that. The Jukes really need to go and defend that, because they'll take quite a lot of damage. It's all kicking off in the jungle. Massive static storm. Ian just gets blown up, but Vop is doing so much damage. But he's got to run away. I don't think he can keep fighting this. Oh, the axe is just trying, but he whiffs the ult. And I think this could be the disruptor going down to the ignite damage. Yes, it is. That was another really good
fight. Ooh,
Vop
was on a mega kill.
Yep, and the sniper's going to get away just because of his blink. And the Naga gets away with basically nothing. But again, all the lanes are pushing in now for Jammys, if they want
to
push this.
And the boosted travel there are probably going to be really helpful if you want to keep pushing.
So this is a Shiva's coming up on the OD, and they're pushing down mid. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. That's a big gold swing. Oh, there's the courier. He's seen the courier, but he can't catch it. Radiant's middle tower is under and the courier goes back, and nice fake back there for the courier. Heading out to the sniper. And that's the BKB finished on Sniper. So, my concern here is the Naga actually. The Naga is going for an axe, I think. He's got the point booster, and I can't imagine it's a Skadi, or a Bloodstone, or an Octarine. So, I think it's got to be axe. And I think a lot of people forget about the Naga axe. But it has quite an impact with the health regen.
Yeah, I mean, and it can really help swing the...
So it's, 50% of your HP back, basically.
And a lot of the ways that the Jammys have been winning fights is by being quite bursty. And so, you know, the Naga ult can really sort of nullify that if she gets it off.
I mean, to be fair, she is second last in net worth.
Yeah, so it's probably going to be a while before
that. Only has the point booster. I mean, she does have 1,000 gold, but she is not farming quickly. She is, you know, she's 1k net worth behind the disruptor. I mean, that's the other good news for the Jammys, is that most of their heroes are up the net worth chart, except the Bane, who is super poor.
Yeah, I mean, he's been, you know, full on position 5.
He's got an Eclens and a cloak, so he's not, like, he's not dirt poor, but he's right down the bottom of the net worth.
Yeah. Is there a way to see how many wards have been bought by the...
No, there isn't, unfortunately.
Alright.
Not until the game.
Yeah, because I would imagine that looking at the way that they've been playing, that the Ogre basically probably was more in charge of actually getting a little bit big, especially given that he got a lot of kills as well.
The Ogre's got full Guardian Greaves now.
Yeah.
And he's now going for his Axe, which is halfway towards. That'll be big. Axe on Ogre doesn't seem like much, but it makes a huge difference having that extra stun.
Yeah.
The only thing is you've got to be very careful, because if you use that stun early on,
you have no mana.
It's an absurd... It's always a fixed percentage of your mana. Is it 10%?
No, it's more than that.
Can't somebody look up the stat for me? But it is quite... It is a lot. It's a fixed percentage of your current mana. That was unfortunate for Vopper. He just got himself stuck up on the cliff.
I don't Don't know why I typed order eggs rather than ogre eggs.
So it's 60% of current mana.
60% of current mana.
Yeah, so it's a lot.
Yeah, if you use it full mana, I mean, at the moment it would cost him basically a 1,000 mana to cast a stun, which, it's almost as bad as Crystal Maiden's ult.
The one thing I would have liked to see, actually before the axe, arguably, is some form of reposition, like a blink or a force staff, because I think, especially the force staff, would be really useful also for getting people out of the disruptor.
Yeah, because the only thing they've got, what you can't... Ult. Oh, you can get out of the op, but you can't get out of kinetic field with a force staff.
Yeah.
I mean, there's the force staff on Vop, obviously, but you're right, apart from the blink on Kian, but apart from that, they don't have any real maneuverability. Even at Yules or something can be quite good on an ogre, just because you have the movement speed and the mana regen that you wouldn't otherwise have. The interesting thing, is it still the case that you can steal in from illusions?
I don't know. I think they patched it out. But I... Podcast voice?
That was pretty broken.
Maybe?
I still think it's kind of broken that illusions count for doing full damage on things like Undying's Tomb.
Well, it's an Undying's Tomb amount of hits. Yes, rather than the
but
amount of damage.
Creeps do a, same with Phoenix Egg. Creeps do whatever it is, 1/5 of a hit. But illusions do full, so some heroes just completely counter it. It's kind of a bit crap. Because you think 5 hits, that's quite a lot, and then you realise, oh wait, if you've got illusions, it's basically 1 hit each. So it's all gone very quiet. I think the Dukes are kind of a bit shell-shocked. They're 12,000 gold behind at this point. Now, the Gyro has really caught up. I've been really impressed because he was 0 for 5 at the start, and he's now got an SMY, got Helm of the Dominator, got his BKB, and he's, second in net worth. Obviously, Vop is miles ahead. He's 7k net worth ahead of the Kunker.
Yeah, Kunker's just building up his Daedalus.
And it looks like he's going Octarine Core, and he's level 22 as well. Oh, and he's going to run into the Naga, but he's going to turn around.
He
should have gone for that. I think it might be too late.
Yeah.
Oh, no, wait. This is potentially dangerous. They need to be very careful here.
Yeah, but...
Okay, they got the triple multicast. I think this might be a dead Andalect. He needs to... BKB. Oh, beautiful BKB, but he gets called. Vop pops his BKB. Comes in. But... He's being silenced by the Static Storm, so he's not getting his orbs off. And the BKB's on everybody. Wow, that's so much damage.
Nice stun.
Even without the orbs, he just does so much right-click damage at the moment. He's hitting for 200.
Alright, I think they can probably push high ground on this.
They need to. They need to do something, because they're just... They're not really doing anything. They need to... push it they either need to take that T2 or they just need to take this mid while they've got time. Farming a creep wave is probably not the best use of Odie's time. They've got 40 seconds. They do a buyback on the Kunker, but that's it. So they could get Rax here quite easily. From his kin's lot, Vop's lost most of his stolen int now, so he's only hitting for 180 damage.
Oh no.
But still.
But that's going to be Octarine Core finish for him as well, because he's now got 4,500 gold.
He's still not used his drums.
No.
Not that he needs to.
No, but I mean, if you think about it, in that last fight where he wasn't really getting. He wasn't able to use his orb because of the combination of the Static Storm initially and then the BKBs, having that extra attack speed does make a big difference.
We go to Yasp and pass this match, it's gonna get unused items.
Oh yeah, under the skills thing. It tells you how good you are.
Oh, you won't be able to actually, because it's a private match.
Oh yeah, good point. Won't get passed. Because it'll be a private lobby. So this will be the only record of the game. Somebody will have to, count the wards meticulously.
I suppose you can't,
They can probably save the replay, right?
I don't know if you can for lobby games.
Because we played a lobby game a while back.
I think you might have it from the console. I don't know.
Yeah.
If there's a...
No, it wasn't my game. Like in my played games, and I could download the replay there.
I think it's only if you play a local lobby that you can't do that. Though if you play online, you don't get. Yeah. Which obviously isn't happening here. Mm. As you can see, we know all about commentating Dota games.
Well, I mean, the only thing I know more about is actually playing the game. Alright, so I think they have an Aegis. I mean,
they do. Are they? And he's got the full Octarine core. Are they going to push this? They're all here. Naga and Sniper are missing. They've got their ults up.
Yeah.
Like, now would not be a bad time to go while Sniper's busy farming Ancients. Problem is they don't know that because they haven't got the vision. So they don't know that, and Naga's coming back.
Alright, so everyone's TPing back.
Yeah. Now it's a bit more risky, because if they get caught, they could get team wiped. Vop is very sensibly staying well back, because the last thing he wants is any kind of problems, and they're just going to send the Gyro up onto the high ground. He's got the Aegis, so, you know, just hit things. However,
he's not actually doing it. You don't want to just
throw the Aegis away, that's the only problem. You know, it's all very well having it, but if you just waste it by running up onto the high ground and dying, and he's not doing a lot of damage, like, he still... I mean, he's only got SMY, and... What? Oh, no, that's Ogre. Why has Ogre bought a Robe of Magi? I'm very confused. He's bought a random Robe of the Magi to go with his Blade of Alacrity, Staff of Wizardry, and Point Booster.
Is he going for a...
He's going for an Axe.
Right, but is he also...
He might be going for Veil? A Veil.
Yeah, but it's...
Because I think he's...
Okay.
I mean, he has enough for the eggs, and then he just adds the stuff for the Veil. I mean,
Veil is excellent on Ogre.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Like, people keep saying, you know, oh, Veil's got better now. You look at it, it's ridiculous, the stats that Veil gives you.
Let's
have a look.
And I mean, a lot of the gyro damage is still magical.
It's 6 HP regen, 6 armor, 6 agi, 6 strength, 6 damage, and 18 intelligence. Just
I mean, it's all the things that Ogre likes.
Yeah. It's one of the like most efficient stat game items in the game now.
And that increased damage, yeah.
If I remember correctly, BKB purges it, but if you apply it to somebody who has BKB up, it stays on them.
Oh, Kian's being caught out here.
So Kian's being Kian.
But he's just BKB'd, and he should get away. I don't know what he's doing. Okay, he's blinking away. He needs to be very careful.
I think
careful
he's just
here.
Being really yeah, no. bad man. Well, I guess he's trying to kind of create space here for...
Okay,
for the Chick
Duke's there. Just run around a tree and stop. The enemy team is going, oh, I don't know where he is now.
Oh, well, you know, it's like when you...
Though, space created.
Yes, he's created, huh?
They are pushing him very hard on the top lane. They're all TPing back in. That's a net onto the Gyro, who still has the Aegis at the moment.
It's got like a minute left.
Yep, and there's the... and they've got the beautiful Bane ult from outside the base. They've got no way of stopping this.
Ooh.
Oh, OD needs to get out of the Static Storm. Oh my god, the damage from OD is absurd. I think this could be it.
Yeah,
I
mean, this seems like a game.
They do have 3 buybacks. 4 buybacks. They've got buybacks. Oh, but no, that's it.
Oh,
GG
no, the GGs
scored.
Are being played.
That's it.
Alright, GG for the Jammys.
That's 1-0.
Fantastic play there from Vopro, and a fantastic comeback from Anderlecht, considering his start. Like, he started really badly, but by the end, he was second.
And Ogre is dancing.
Well, I mean, Ogre did a lot of work, let's be honest. Yeah. He got all the early kills for him. So, well done to the Jammys. They tie the series 1-1.
Right, I mean, as always, making life fun for the